Right. It's been a fabulous fair.
And that's right. A News 4 St. Louis Nightside.
Football team here in St. Louis. And I just wanted to let you know that we are definitely not leaving town.
Hi, I'm Mike Owens from Channel 5 Eyewitness News, and I never watch Worldwide Magazine.
Because you asked for it. From around the corner, from around the nation, from around the world. Yes, it's Worldwide Magazine, winner of hundreds of radio TV awards, and seen in dozens of foreign countries via satellite. Hi, this is PEP, and we got a great show today, so don't go away. Don't touch that dial. You'll be making the biggest mistake of your life. On today's show, we have an interview with the one, the only Dino of Dino's Bungalow. Also on today's show, a look at the Hullabaloo Fashion Show that took place several weeks ago at the South Broadway Athletic Club. Some of the clothes that you won't find at JCPenney's. Marty liked it a lot. Also today, by special arrangement, an interview with Wanda. And you might ask who Wanda is. There she is. She's the spokesperson for Veterans Carpet Bargains. And she'll be telling us the secrets of the carpet business. And also, some music from Big George and the House Rockers. And a look at our visit to Tower Grove Park, where we were welcomed with open arms. So sit back, relax, and enjoy another edition of Worldwide Magazine.
Hi, everybody. This is Buffalo Bob. And I never watch Worldwide Magazine. Right, Clarabelle?
Does the jitterbug, just a silly look. Young and wild with lots of style is does the jitterbug.
Recently, Worldwide Magazine took its cameras for a personal appearance at Tower Grove Park. The results were truly underwhelming.
Here we are, ladies and gentlemen. We're at Tower Grove Park. It's 12 noon. Oh, no, it's 1 o'clock. Well, just changed the clock, so I don't know what time it is. It's 2 o'clock. No, it's actually 1:15 or something. Anyway, we're here, and there's like thousands of people here. There's a lot of people that way in the background. You can't see them because of the, you know, problems with the camera. There's millions of people here, and we're here with the Worldwide regulars. And boy, these people, are they going to be disappointed because, you know, we're not going to do anything. But wait a second. We do have our free gifts. Well, maybe we should hold off giving out the free gifts because you might leave if you get your free fly swatter. So maybe we better hold off on that. Big Daddy?
What?
Could you give us some facts about this park?
No, I don't know nothing about this park. Other than it's kind of like the state of Texas, all they got is steers and queers.
Over here, Big Daddy, could you believe it? Big Daddy is selling autographed pictures. I can't believe it.
$5 a piece.
How much are those pictures? They're only $1 each. He's not making that much money on them. And we got our fly swatters, and we have our autographed pictures, and that's about it. Now, first off, we want to bring up one of our favorite people, the guy that really kind of made me what I am today, is people like this. Marty, come on over here, Marty. Let's hear it for Marty. Marty's going to talk to you for a while.
Yeah. Hey, I'm glad I got some supporting fans out here. If it wasn't for you guys, I wouldn't be nothing. I don't know, maybe I ain't nothing, but I am something now, so thanks a lot, especially Big Daddy up here, he rules the wrestling world, like him. Hey, I like you, great, especially last night, that was good last night. So anyhow, I'm glad everybody came.
That's what you're gonna say,
Mark? I don't know. I say this is
okay, Marty,
this is great.
On your what? Tell the truth.
I got a gun right here.
Marty has a gun with him, so if anyone leaves, you know, it's your responsibility. And now we're coming up to our stage, the one, the only, the biggest man in show business.
I got nothing to say right now.
Big Daddy. Here he is.
I'm busy.
Okay, now who wants some pictures of me? I got pictures here. They're free.
Not everybody at once.
Okay, here you go. Well, I mean, just come on up here. You get a picture. Okay, where are your kids from?
New York.
Where are you from?
St. Louis.
Well, what street you live on?
Shea, yeah.
Shea? Now, do you live in a nice house?
Yeah.
You live on the first floor or the second floor?
No. On the first.
On the first floor? Does your parents, do they have a lot of VCRs and televisions and stuff?
Yeah.
Okay, what's your address?
Don't tell them.
88659.
88659. Okay, and your parents work during the day?
No.
Okay. All right, so will you actually watch the show?
Yeah.
Really? How come?
It was neat.
When was the last show you watched? What was the last time you watched?
Last Friday.
Went to the apartments. That was weeks ago. Kids, get out of here. You haven't even watched it lately. Hey, what's wrong with these kids?
We'll be back with more stuff from Tower Grove Park later on today, including the nude beauty contest. Be watching.
Just driving down the road, and we were in Collinsville, Illinois, and we just saw one of my favorite places. I've seen this place on TV literally, I would say, hundreds of times, but I've never been here before, so when I saw it, I just had to come in, and we're at Veterans Carpet Bargains. Is that right?
Right.
And we're talking to the lady that I guess a lot of you might recognize from regular TV, because she's been in many commercials. She's like a St. Louis celebrity. And, of course, we're talking to Wanda.
Wanda Hunter, yes.
Okay, now how long have you been with the carpet industry here?
28 years.
No, you're not that old.
Okay.
You must have started when you were 4 or 5 years old, right?
About that.
And, excuse me, there's two stores that this company owns, Veterans Carpet, and then over there, I guess, in, what, St. Charles or something? Where do they own the other store?
In Hazelwood.
Okay, and that's Carpet Bargains.
Right.
Now, why don't they have the same name for both stores?
I really don't know why he didn't name them both the same.
And how did you get to be picked to do the TV commercials?
I don't know. I guess because I'm the only woman that works in this store, and I guess they wanted a woman to do them.
Okay, has your life changed much since you've done these commercials?
All my customers know me now by name.
Do people come in and ask for you?
Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, it's the power of television. I guess the TV commercials have really helped the business here.
Yes, they helped a lot.
Otherwise, you wouldn't be advertising so much.
Right.
And I guess you guys are the number one advertisers for carpets in St. Louis. I guess nobody else advertises as much.
I really don't know. We advertise a lot.
Yeah, I know. A lot. So let me ask you something now. What is Becky really like? I guess I always see, you know, I've seen you, then I see the next show Becky, and they show Wanda, then Becky, and Becky and Wanda. Now, tell me, could you give us a little scoop about what Becky's really like?
What do you mean, what's she really like?
Like, what is she like? What does she like to do when she's not selling carpet?
She trains her Dobermans.
Oh, she has Doberman pinchers?
Mm-hmm.
Does she have any kids?
No.
Just dogs.
Oh,
okay. Well, before we go, could you just do like part of the commercial for us? You know, you must have it memorized. Okay, I'll be Becky, and you can be Wanda. Okay. So hold on a second. Here we go.
I'm Wanda from Veterans Carpet. We have 9x12 carpets on special for $29.95.
Hi, and this is Becky from Carpet and Tile Bargains. See, Becky couldn't be here today, so I'm playing Becky's part. Okay. Hey, listen, could you show me that $29 carpet? I've always wanted to see it. Where, you got one? You got it around here, don't you?
They're in the back.
It's in the back? I say it's not worth too much trouble to see it, but it's really nice carpet, I can tell you that. Well, thank you very much. I really appreciate it, and you're a real nice lady. And I guess, you know, if you guys are going to buy carpet, you know, this is not an advertisement for the place, but if you're going to buy carpet, you should at least, you know, check this place out, because they sell a lot of carpet, so they probably can maybe help you out. So check it out. Hi, this is PEP reminding you about our big, big night that's coming up November 28th at Dino's Bungalow. That's at the corner of Leona and Bates. It's going to be November 28th. That's the Saturday after Thanksgiving. And all the crazy guys and gals from Dino's are going to be there to put on a fabulous show for you. We'll be taping and presenting it as an event on Worldwide Magazine. Now, the last time we had a show here, it was packed. And we had a great time. That's why we're coming back. And this time we hope it's going to be even more fun than the last time. And it was pretty much fun the last time. So come on down November 28th to Dino's Bungalow, Leona and Bates. And it's free. Doesn't cost anything to go in. I would suggest if you're going to come a little bit early, because the last time it was really packed. So come on down November 28th. Dino's Bungalow, Leona and Bates, as Worldwide Magazine presents...
Hi, this is Bill Birdbrain saying hello to all you cable viewers out there. And the story is, if I don't get no dome, you know I've got to roam. I don't care about you St. Louis people. And I'll tell you why I don't care. Because you're too cheap to get out to Busch Stadium and spend a few $20 bills for a couple of hot dogs, and so you can watch our good-looking cheerleaders down there. Well, if you don't like it, too bad, because we're leaving, and we're never coming back again.
You know, Tower Grove Park is one of the most beautiful parks in the city, and believe it or not, it's not a city park. It's a private park that was started by a trust from the old Henry Shore. It's filled with all kinds of neat trees that you can't find elsewhere. Anyway, here's some beautiful scenes from the park, and we're gonna go back now and hear some music from Big George, who played at our personal appearance.
business?
It's slow.
It's slow?
Yeah, today.
Do you sell more pretzels in the winter or the summer?
Summer.
In the summer?
Yeah.
Now, does it pay well selling pretzels?
Get half what I make.
What?
Get half what I make.
It's half what you make?
Uh-huh.
I mean, how about on a good day? You do pretty well selling pretzels?
Yeah, I make about, maybe $50 a day.
$50?
Yeah.
From selling pretzels?
Yeah.
That's pretty good. Well, how long have you been in the pretzel business?
About 8 years, going on 9.
Well, what'd you used to do?
I used to work at, Western Liquor Place.
You used to work at Channel 11?
No, Western Liquor.
Oh, okay. I thought you said Channel 11. Well, anything exciting happening selling pretzels? What's the most exciting thing that's ever happened to you when you were selling pretzels?
I made about $100 one day.
How'd you do that?
My girlfriend helped me.
She must have been good looking.
Yeah, it was good that day. Yeah,
those are kind of salty, those pretzels. How much are they?
Quarter a piece, a dollar a bag.
Dollar a bag. And there's three in a bag?
Four.
Four?
Yeah.
Oh. Not much incentive to buy a bag.
Yeah,
it'd be a break, you know, if you buy a bag, maybe you get an extra pretzel or something.
About his haircut.
Hey, we talked to these kids here. Tell me about your haircut.
It's down to the skin. Like, skin like that. You just cut it down this side and cut it on this side. Cut it in the back.
Let me just tell you something, ladies and gentlemen. So I'm like 39 years old, unfortunately. And when I was a kid, when I was growing up, it was in the 60s. There was a lot of things going on in the 60s. There was revolution. People were protesting the Vietnamese War. There was drugs and hippies and all that stuff. And there was a lot of people that at the time were dressing to kind of express a statement about what they thought of society. And we thought they were kind of strange back then. But years have passed now, and looking back, I gotta say one thing, they were pretty stupid. So, wait a second, hey guys.
One of your speeches did the trick, Pete, they're all asleep. Hey, can I say one thing about that guy's haircut?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't try this at home.
Okay, now you get any? Do you get any?
I like it.
Do you get any trouble when you're? Do you get any trouble when you're in school?
No, they just attack me and throw me down staircases and stuff like that.
Well, I think that this is America, ladies and gentlemen. This is a country. Yeah. That was built on the freedom of doing what you want.
And you're pushing me.
There's a creed that I live by. It's the creed of America. The creed where anybody, no matter whether you're rich or poor, or no matter what color you are, or no matter what religion you belong to, it's the kind of thing. Well, anyway, this guy. Hey, what's going on?
I think you lost him again.
Pete. Oh, Jesus!
Hey, you better stop these monologues.
Okay. So now this guy here, and I gotta say one thing: is his stupid haircut? Okay, so it looks stupid. So.
All right, that's it. I don't think my hair is stupid at all. Okay, he agrees my hair is cool, right?
That's right.
Come here.
Okay.
You agree that my hair is cool, right?
I would say.
Do you
that,
like your microphone?
I would say that.
You're losing control of this interview.
This is America, ladies and gentlemen. This is the United States.
It's the greatest country
in the whole world.
Cable viewer and fans, this is your friend Bill Birdbrain reporting in person about the controversy concerning the dead birds leaving Bush Stadium. And it's true that we are leaving because we don't care, because you St. Louis fans stink because you think about his baseball and getting 3 million into a stadium. Well, why can't you get 3 million in a stadium for the big dead? Because they stink, and I know you people have a good touch of class for football teams that stink and things that are cheap here in this cheap cow town, St. Louis. And that's why Bill Birdbrain does whatever he wants to do.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, this is Big Daddy talking to you. I want you to come down to Dino's Bungalow on November the 28th, the Saturday night after Thanksgiving. We're having a worldwide magazine get-together down there. You might get on television with Big Daddy and Gino here. So get your butts on down there and check us out, all right? All right? Say all right, Gino. All right. All right.
This is P.E.P. I'm behind the bar at Dino's. And I want to remind you about our big show coming up November 28th. That's the Saturday after Thanksgiving. Now, the place is kind of empty right now, but it's going to be packed that night as the people stream in to see some of the most unbelievable entertainment available anywhere. So you don't want to miss it. Our last show in April was a big success here. That's why we're coming back, and we're going to make it even bigger and better than ever. So come on down and see the event of the year as Worldwide Magazine presents An Evening with Dino's. Admission is free, and Dino's is located at Leona and Bates. So come on down. That's Saturday, November 28th, the Saturday after Thanksgiving. We want to see your face in the place.
Say, kids, what time is it? Oh, it's Howdy Doody time. Yes, sir. And it's going to be Howdy Doody time on Channel 11 when we do our big, big two-hour special, Howdy's 40th anniversary show, and that'll be on Tuesday night, November 24, 7 to 9 p.m. We'll see you then. Hi, everybody. This is Buffalo Bob, and I never watch Worldwide Magazine. Right, Clarabelle?
That's our P.O. Box 39333, St. Louis, Missouri, 63139. If you have an idea for the show or want to be on it or something else, just write us a letter. There's a really neat store on South Broadway in St. Louis. It's called the Hullabaloo Store. It features clothing from the 60s and the 70s, and it's a real, real neat place. Recently, they had a fashion show during wrestling matches, bizarre as it might sound. And we're going to show you some of the fashions that are available at Hullabaloo. So let's take a look and see some of the clothes that you won't get at JCPenney's.
Take this from me, folks. Tis the new. Oh, it's hot. Be folks. Call her new. On after step, quick step. Like the seizures do. I'll go into your trick step. And that's Hullabaloo. Or cheek to cheek. With one hand on your hip. On side, one side. And as you do, you get a twinkling clap hand. Do stomp to.
Valley girl, she's a valley girl. Okay, fine, for sure, she's a valley girl.
Thanks to all the nice people at Hullabaloo, and that was the Hullabaloo Fashion Show right here on Worldwide Magazine.
I didn't come here prepared to make no speeches, but since I had the opportunity, you people know, see, most of you people weren't at the matches last night, and that's why you're here today, because if you were there last night, you were too bored with coming down here today. But anyway, as you know, last night, Big Daddy, everybody that Big Daddy brought in, kicked all the butt like they always do. If you don't come to the matches, you're stupid, and you should be down there because I rule the wrestling world, and don't ever forget it. Fans love me. Listen to them clapping. See, I tell you people in St. Louis all the time, but I rule the wrestling world. And now to Steve Bailey.
No, wrong.
No?
It's Frank Shamel, director of parks here. I don't know. Do you have a permit for this, Mr. Parisi?
This guy here is from Mayor Shamel's office. He's from the park. And he's trying to throw us out because we don't have any permits or anything.
Okay. Do y'all have your individual attendance permits? We'll have to see those. I'm going to send some of our representatives through the crowd to check everybody's individual attendance permits. If you don't have the attendance permits, y'all are going to have to get out of here.
Yeah. Big George, show him your blues belt. There's the blues belt that Big George has just won. And if you've been watching our show last week, Big George just won it back. And boy, I'm going to tell you one thing, he really deserves it. So here's Big George.
Thank you. Work hard for this belt. I'm intending to keep it this time. Bye.
Places that are nicer than Dino's. They might have, you know, newer furniture. They might be in a better neighborhood. They might have more, you know, prettier bartenders and all that kind of jazz. But there's no place like Dino's. Dino's has a real spirit to it, a real atmosphere. It's filled with great people. And the thing that makes Dino's a great place are the great people that come there. So I want to remind you that Dino's is going to be the site for a special taping of Worldwide Magazine. It's going to be November 28th, and it's free. So come on down. The last time we had a show here, it was like, boy, it was a lot of people.
It was packed.
Yeah, people couldn't even stand up.
All people.
Right, so you might want to come a little early.
Stay late.
Well, you know, the last time you had all those tables reserved, you know, we're not going to, you leave a few tables open for people to just come in off the street, won't you?
We'll do our best.
Right, it was kind of crowded the last time, but it was a lot of fun, and that was in April, so we're going to do another show here on November 28th. Now, it's the Saturday after Thanksgiving. Hopefully, I guess a lot of you guys won't be real busy that night.
Oh, they'll probably be full of stuffed with turkey.
Right, you'll be stuffed with entertainment after you come to Dino's. Hey, Dino, how long you been at this place? How long has this been Dino's Bungalow?
Well, I'm here 15 years, November the 10th.
And it was somebody else's bungalow before that?
Yeah, this is 53 years old.
The place is 53 years old,
right.
And it has never been remodeled.
Right. Only patched up.
Right, right, right. So, now this beer garden over here is the oldest
existing
outdoor beer garden in St. Louis. Is that right?
Existing.
What does that mean?
Oldest existing. That means there was others before, but they're no longer in existence.
This is a survivor, this beer garden. Right.
Right.
And, you know, St. Louis is the home of a large German population, and I guess that's where the idea of beer gardens came from Germany.
I think so.
Right. So, but the beer garden's going to be closed. So
yeah.
Don't.
It's open to my two dogs.
There'll be vicious dogs roaming the beer garden. So if you go there and accidentally wander into the beer garden, you might get maimed. So anyway, November 28th, that's a Saturday after Thanksgiving. Dino's going to be there. His band is going to be there. Matt Sishoff, if he doesn't pass away or anything, is going to be there.
What are you about, Kyle? Get him off! Get him off! I'm okay, fine. Thank you, Theo. Good man, good one. Good people. What a nice one.
Pat's going to be there.
Yeah, that's our bungalow mayor.
Who?
Pat.
Patchy's the mayor of the bungalow. Now you'll never forget Pat if you hear us sing.
Am I blue? Are these tears in my eyes telling you? Am I blue? Honey, you'd be too.
And, well, we're going to have some other people that we're not going to announce just yet. A lot of famous people might be coming, but then again, maybe they won't. But you might be coming, and then again, maybe you won't. So anyway, I'll be here, probably.
I'll be here.
He'll be here. He owns the place. He's got to be here.
Right.
So that's at Dino's Bungalow, Leona and Bates, November 28th. That's the Saturday after Thanksgiving. Admission is free, and there'll be fun and frivolity for all.
Be there.
Yay!
Hey, Pete, you know, I'm really, really mad about this stock and all this collapse.
About the big stock market crash?
Yeah, this is getting pretty serious, you know. But
you got a lot of money in the stock market,
right? Right, I got about 5,000 shares in this consolidated meme company, you know, big stock market. And a lot of money invested in my gun stock. The world gun stock.
Well, you, speaking of guns, I just saw you brought your rifle here. Now, where are you going with that rifle?
Well, I'm so mad I have to go over and take care of this problem with my broker because I trusted him with all my money putting this into the stocks that I just don't know what to do to it. So I'm going to have to go over here and settle this out with my broker because I'm...
Okay, well, listen, if you're going near the broker, you're going to be going near the copying place. Could you run off this for me, please?
Let's see here, what's it say? Dear Worldwide Magazine fan, due to the tremendous volume of mail, please excuse the delay in answering your letter.
That's right.
Pete, how many of these do you want? How many copies?
Make about seven of them.
Okay, alrighty. I'll see why we can't get this taken care of for you.
Hey, Ben Marty, well, what about that picture? You got those? Oh, you see those pictures there, Marty?
Yeah. Hey, Pete, these are my new pictures.
New pictures, huh, Marty?
Yeah, brand new pictures I just had made today.
And you're gonna offer these for our viewers?
Yeah, just for the ASDI.
For the what?
Just for the ASDI. I'm trying to be a nice guy.
That's a nice picture, Mark.
I've been having so many requests for pictures that now I got them available. I want to see how many people actually want one. So hey, if you want one of these pictures, you can just send
a self-addressed stamped envelope.
To Worldwide Magazine.
That's Worldwide Magazine, P.O. Box 39333, St. Louis, Missouri 6319. Hey, Marty, how much
much did you pay for those pictures, anyway?
Well, it didn't cost me anything, because I stole these.
You stole them?
Yeah, I stole
them. Hey, listen, Marty, I'm not kidding now. There's a creed that I live by, and I believe that honesty is the best policy, and that nothing can be gained from stealing. And if you're going to steal, always steal from a big company, you know, as opposed to a small. It's not as bad. So try to steal like from big companies, Sears, JCPenney.
How about Walmart? That's pretty big.
Walmart, right. Well,
we're here at Schmuck Supermarket asking our shoppers what they think of our new higher prices.
I like it a lot better now that they raised the price because I enjoy my food more than now that I pay more.
I like shopping better now that they raised 300 prices.
I don't like using coupons. I like paying full prices for my food.
I enjoy shopping a lot more since they raised 3,000 prices.
At Schmuck's, the price of being poor has just gone up.
I get a lot more enjoyment out of my food when I pay high prices.
I like paying full price for my food.
At Schmuck's, we have 3,000 higher prices. Why pay less?
I get a lot more enjoyment out of my food when I pay high prices.
Okay, we're only kidding. We didn't mean anything by that. Everybody always gets mad at everything we do. We're just trying to have a good time. You know, we didn't mean anything, you know. Just kidding.
Hi, this is Bill Birdbrain saying hello to all you cable viewers out there. And the story is, if I don't get no dome, you know I've got to roam. I don't care about you St. Louis people. And I'll tell you why I don't care. Because you're too cheap to get out to Busch Stadium and spend a few $20 bills for a couple of hot dogs and so you can watch our good-looking cheerleaders down there. Well, if you don't like it, too bad, because we're leaving. And we're never coming back again.
Hey, you have horseback riding in the park?
No, this is this guy's going away party. He's going over to Illinois for the winter, so they have a little going away party for him.
So the guy or the horse?
The horse.
Oh, come over here, come over here. Let me talk to the horse.
Let me talk to the horse. This is Justice. He's owned by Tagro Park.
Oh, and then what are you? Are you a Tagro?
I'm a St. Louis policeman that rides the horse for him, for Tagro Park.
Oh, it's like a part-time job?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, with a nice horse.
He's going over to Illinois for the winter, and so we had a little going away party for him.
What is he doing in Illinois in the winter?
He's just going over to a farm over in Troy, to a stable.
Oh, it's kind of like a vacation for the horse.
Yeah, a vacation farm, yeah.
And who are these nice people?
Oh, these are friends of ours and friends of the horses, you know.
The horse has his own friends?
Yeah, that's right. He's got little boyfriends and girlfriends here.
Well, yeah.
He's pregnant, but he didn't have anything to do with it.
Hey, I love horses. You know John Wayne? I was just reading about John Wayne. Did you know that John Wayne hated horses?
Oh, really?
Yeah, I just read that. It was in the National Enquirer.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, they had a big story about how he hated horses.
Huh.
Said he'd only go on a horse if the cameras were rolling. Well, say goodbye, horsey.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye. See you later, folks.
Bye, Peter. Goodbye.
Enjoy the park.
Thank you.
Mark.
Good afternoon. How are you?
What are you
doing here?
Oh,
I'm his interpreter. Okay. What'd you think about last week's Wall Street crash? Did it have a lot of effect on the ninja business?
Yeah.
He said he lost quite a bit. That's really terrible.
What's your name?
My name's Teresa DiLiberto.
What?
Teresa DiLiberto, D-I-L-I-B-E-R-T-O, capital L.
Okay, what's your address? What's your phone number?
That was next.
I live on Gurney, which is like right near here.
You get a fan, I'm gonna show. You better hold it, and I'll pick up the dough. You work hard, get my pride. Be right there, by your side. I'll go with you, my baby.
It's been a great time. I want to thank especially Big George and the House Rockers. Don't forget that Big George and the House Rockers can be heard every Friday and Saturday night at Taylor and Delmar at the new Club Caravan. It's a great place, and it's some really great entertainment. You've got to check it out. And I want to thank all the wonderful people, the thousands of great Worldwide Magazine fans that took time out of their busy day to come here and be part of our show. And we got a lot of show. What's the matter? Why didn't you enjoy it? What are you guys? Guys, come on, I'm gonna go home now. I'm gonna go home, everybody. You're shutting over. It's not connected.
Once again, I'd like to thank Big George and the House Rockers, Joe Don, and all the nice people that came out to visit us at Tower Grove Park. We had a good time, in spite of what you might have seen. And I want to remind everybody that November 28th, that's the day of days, the show of shows at the place of places, Dino's Bungalow, Leona and Bates. Now, it's free, and we want everyone to come if you're not doing anything better, and that's not hard. So it's November 28th, Saturday night after Thanksgiving. It's free. It's going to be an evening at Dino's. We'll be taping it and broadcasting it on the cable. So be on the scene. That's November 28th at Dino's Bungalow, Leona and Bates. We want to see your face in the place. This is PEP saying thanks a lot to all you people that were silly enough to be on our program tonight. And all you people out there that were silly enough to watch it. We'll see you later. Bye.